Hi guys, welcome back to our channel. After taking apart a 65W power bank from Baseus, ChargerLAB got another 65W power bank from Baseus. But this time, it comes with an undetachable orange cable. You can conveniently charge USB-C devices without a separate cable. Okay, let's go ahead and take it apart to see what it looks like inside. Like all the Baseus products, all the specs info are printed on the back. Tear off the sealing strip and open the box. Except for the power bank, there are also some documents and stickers inside. Take it out from the plastic bag and remove the plastic film that protects the display. We found the front of the power bank can be divided into two parts. The lower part adopts matte fire retardant PC engraved with 65W, and the upper part is a display showing the real-time battery percentage. The 20,000 mAh is on one side, so the capacity can be quickly checked when boarding. The power button is on the other side. Flip to the back, we can find all the specs info in detail. Modlist PPJL65C. The single cell capacity is 5000 mAh, 74Wh in total. The USB-C can support up to 65W input and output, and the USB-A can support 30W output. It also has passed the CE and FCC certifications. Let's take a closer look at the orange USB-C cable on the top. It supports 65W fast charging and discharging. Except for the orange cable, there are another two USB-C and two USB-A ports. But the USB-C port under the cable is not used for charging. Just insert the USB-C connector to fix the cable. It can also be regarded as a strap to carry around. The power bank size is about 152x68x28mm, and the length is about 17.6cm. The weight is about 423 grams. The ChargerLAB Power ZKM002C shows the USB-C supports FCP, AFC, PD3.0, PPS, QC4, Apple 2.4A verticals. And it supports 5 fixed PDLs of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 12V, 3A, 15V, 3A, 20V, 3.25A, and a set of PPS. But the built-in USB-C cable only supports PD3.0, PPS, and QC4 protocols. Like the USB-C port, it also supports 5 fixed PDLs and a set of PPS. The USB-A1 supports FCP, SCP, AFC, QC3.0, Apple 2.4A, and Samsung 5V 2A protocols. And the other USB-A port supports the same protocols as the USB-A1, so you don't need to distinguish which is better. After the brief introduction of this power bank, let's go ahead and take apart to see its internal structure and components. Let's start from the bottom and use the spudger to pry along the gap. There is a film pasted on the front of the battery for buffering. The battery cells and the USB-C cable are connected to this PCBA module and is fixed by screws. The solder joints of those thin wires are reinforced with white silicone adhesives. This USB socket is not connected to PCBA module, just fixed by screws. Remove all the screws and separate the PCBA module. Cut off the positive and negative wires and insulate them with black tape. The module actually consists of two separate PCBs. Let's take out the battery pack. It consists of four battery cells connected in series, and each one is 5000 mAh. Ready voltage is 3.7 volts. The film is attached to the button for buffering, and the battery tabs are pasted with green barley paper for insulation. Remove the barley paper. The battery protection PCB is under it. Eight battery tabs are spot welded through the protection PCB. The battery protection chip is from CellWise, which supports 3 to 4 lithium battery cells. Those two battery protection MOSFETs are from AOS and adopt DFN 3x3 package, 30V, 4.1 mA. Back to the PCBA module, we can see the segment display, USB-A and USB-C connectors, and the protocol chip, MCU, and some MOSFETs are also on the front. Flip to the back, it has a synchronous buck boost circuit and a buck circuit. Let's slowly separate those two PCBs. Three inductors and corresponding filter capacitors are between those two PCBs. The MOS controller is an MCU from Eastsoft, which controls different functions and the display. And the clock rate is 20 MHz. The protocol chip comes from Chipsea, which supports USB PD 3.0. The synchronous buck boost controller is from Southchip, used for the bidirectional buck boost output of the USB-C port. The synchronous buck boost MOSFET is from AOS, same as the battery protection MOSFET. Those two VBUS MOSFET of USB-C are from Goford Semi and adopt DFN 3x3 package. They are connected in series, 30 volts, 10.6 mA. The protocol chip of USB-A is from Ismartware. It supports independent current limiting of dual port and multi-fast charging protocols. This is the buck boost inductor of USB-A. Here are the buck inductor and filter capacitor of USB-A. And this is the VBUS MOSFET of USB-A. This is the segment display we just mentioned. And the power button is fixed by through-hole soldering. This is a voltage regulator chip that powers the MCU and protocol chip. Well, that's all components of this Baseus 65W laptop power bank. Compared to other products, the biggest difference is that it comes with a USB-C cable, which can be used as a strap. Very clever design. After taking apart, we found that it combines two USB-Cs into one, making full use of the space. And the insulation and protection measures are very comprehensive. Okay, that's all for today's video. You can also click the corners to check other Baseus products. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us if you like this video. I'll catch you guys in the next one.